Morning, everyone. I'm Mukta Atre. I'm the coordinator for this project of a very important national stature. How many of you have heard of the National Virtual Library of India? You have? In what way? Right, it's not been launched as yet. We are planning to launch it sometime towards the end of this year. And the project actually started only last year, and we still have another year to go. Okay. All of you must have been hearing a lot about teaching and learning, so we thought that we should talk about something else just to divert you. The National Virtual Library of India came into existence only after the Ministry of Culture commissioned a very high level committee to find out what the situation of the libraries and the information science sector is in India. And what they found was very, very disturbing. They found that a lot of the information in the country is in a very, very diverse kind of way. It's not organized. It's lying around in forgotten libraries and all kinds of things. So the government decided to take a very strong step in this direction, and they set up the National Mission on Libraries in 2012. And from the National Mission on Libraries came the NVLI, the National Virtual Library of India, and that was set up most importantly for the development of libraries and the information science sector. This is the vision of NVLI, that is to empower people, all the people, anybody in India with the right information, whatever they want to know, they should be able to get it. In order to create a knowledge society, though you must have heard the Prime Minister say this several times, and he also wants to set up a particular organization for the preservation of digital content. So far, only about 30% of the content that we have in libraries, in museums, in various organizations, only that much is digitalized. So the National Virtual Library of India. And these are the objectives. We want to create very, very user-friendly interfaces, and these interfaces will involve libraries, archives, museums, and all kinds of other preservation organizations. And these are the various bodies that will be covered: cultural objects, rare books, orphan books, books which do not have any particular library source, things like that, museum objects, manuscripts, and the National Archives of India. So in 2016, they set up the National Virtual Library of India, and these are the partner institutes, IGNU and CDAC Pune, while IIT Bombay is the principal investigator, that's the main organizer. And these are the various roles and responsibilities. We are setting up a very large cloud infrastructure to you need a place to store all these things that we are trying to digitalize. So we are creating a very huge cloud infrastructure. And then we also are, since we have our expertise in training large people at a time, we are concentrating on training large number of library personnel, because we also need to train people how to use these digitalized objects. And then, of course, you cannot have just a single authority or a single entity doing all this. So we are also focusing on creating and establishing collaborative communities. While CDAC Pune is building the bulk of all the applications which are to be used on the website, on the portal, and several critical aspects are being covered. They call them bubbles. And if you go to the NVLI site, if you're interested, you'll find the whole details in on that site. And then IGNU, because they have the expertise in metadata harvesting, they are doing that, and they're indexing the major digital assets which are originating from various libraries across the country. Now, coming to IIT Bombay, I'd like to give you the current status. The status is we are just putting up the operational cloud with a 3 PB storage, and we have various associated infrastructure components going into place. The process is going on. And we have also announced these training programs. There is going to be a foundation course on the use of ICT. We find that across the country, especially library personnel, while they do have computers in their libraries, not all of them are trained in the use of ICT. And we're going to be teaching them how to use ICT for preservation of these digital objects. So we have the training program in Koha, and they're going to be using Koha for most of the digitalizing. We've already finished a pilot workshop training people here in IIT itself, and in June we plan to train something like 25 to 30,000 people across the country. Another very important responsibility that was given to us at IIT Bombay was to create a portal for eminent personalities of India. We have completed, I mean, the pilot was the Sardar Patel, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel portal. It was launched on 31st October by the Honorable Prime Minister. And it contains a whole lot of contents on Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, things like his letters, speeches, various decrees. Then you know what Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was most famous for? Anybody? For bringing the erstwhile princely states into the Indian Union. He was most famous for unifying India. So we have letters of, you know, concession which the kingdoms gave to the to India and things like that. There are a whole lot of rare documents in this website. Do visit it. I've given the address up there. And we've done not just a collection of all the digital material that there is, but we've also been creating translations. We are translating at the moment into three languages, into Marathi, Hindi, and into Gujarati. And because the front end is in Drupal, we've contributed in a big way to the Drupal community as well. And at the moment, we are just in the process of optimizing the portal for better use, better user experience, and various other things. That's the status for the Sardar Patel website. And we've also been doing other things, very important things, like we've created terms of service and policies for the National Virtual Library of India. You understand that when we are sharing such a huge amount of data, there has to be all kinds of rules and regulations in place so that people do not misuse this data. We've been creating memorandums of understanding between various libraries, various organizations, so that we could use the data in a better way. Then we've created a portal where all the data, everything regarding the administration of this huge project is put on. That's called the Confluence. If any person sitting in the ministry in Delhi wants to see a particular letter or a particular order or minutes of the meeting, he can find everything on Confluence. And then we've been doing the project management training across the three organizations that are there, and we've been giving them progress tracking tools as well. So now, coming to the last point of my presentation, we are focusing, and this is what you will be working, some of you will be working on today, I mean, in this internship, is the collaborating communities. We cannot, obviously, one organization cannot do everything, so we will be crowdsourcing and we will be creating collaborative communities. Nitin will be talking a bit more in detail about it, but these are the major components of the system that we are trying to build here. We want to focus on content publishing, localization for Indian languages, then content versioning, most important, event logging and crowdsourcing, etc. So thank you very much. That is what I had to say about the NVLI to you all. I hope you're interested enough to go to this website and also to take part in the projects. Thank you very much.